Hi, my name is Pierre, so I'm the market lead for our tax and accounting division at Thomson Reuters in MENA, and I've been working for the past 3 years now, really, on the introduction of VAT in this region. So I think, you know, the finance function has basically been tasked with VAT in most companies, right? Because a lot of companies here did not really have a tax department, either a huge one or not at all in the first place. So usually that kind of came upon the finance function to kind of do that. One of the things that I think people have realized is they had to elevate that tax conversation as finance to the board, right, and make these stakeholders realize that there is a cost involved in getting ready and that they should not wait until the last minute to actually do this. So I think that was a quick realization, and I think that's how, you know, finance people here had to overcome these type of challenges, right? It's trying to elevate that conversation and also working very, very closely with IT. We've seen a lot of disconnect between these two functions where finance were doing one thing on their end and IT was thinking of doing another thing on their end, and even the KPI in terms of what is a successful VAT implementation were not aligned at all. So that kind of key communication between these two functions is critical, really, and you should always think about that even after you have implemented that. And finally, the other thing that I think was kind of striking here is how finance had all the burden on them, even though it's a company-wide impact, where as VAT touches every single function from marketing to legal to sales to everything. But for some reason, people thought that this was incumbent on the finance function, which again, they had to kind of get out of their comfort zone and explain to every single stakeholders, not just their board or not just IT, but to everybody what actually VAT means in the first place. So I think the role of that finance function had to evolve regardless, because they had to. And I think going forward, they will be expected to manage VAT in a way that is, I would say, compliant from a business point of view, but also efficient as well. So that they are expecting that to claim the right amount of VAT every time and try to manage that cash flow very closely, which is one of the, you know, one of the challenges that you have in a VAT world. I think, you know, most companies hopefully have realized that the 1st of January 2018 in the UAE and Saudi was not the end of the journey, but only the beginning, right? Yes, you got ready, that's great, but now you have to be compliant for the rest of your life. So your journey will never end in that sense. But one of the things that they have to think about is, you know, how can they improve? Because regardless of what you have done in terms of homework, you are not perfect. No one has a perfect VAT process or even a tax process. So there is always a way that you can improve. And one of the things that I would really urge people to think about is the kind of trend that we're seeing globally in terms of how often now you have governments asking you for raw data. So you have the example of the standard audit file for tax in Europe. You've got the SII in Spain, where basically the government is asking you for more data more often. Now, you also have one of the extreme, which is happening right now, which is Poland. So Poland, about a couple of weeks ago, have completely got rid of their VAT return as of 2019, and now are only doing their safety, which means that as a company, the only thing that you are expected to do is have the raw data in the correct format in your company, and then the government can just chip in whenever they feel like it. You don't even need to file a VAT return anymore because they have all the data that they need to be able to check that you're, what you're doing as a VAT process is right. I'm not saying this will happen tomorrow here in the UAE or Saudi or even in the wider GCC, but this is the trend that you're seeing globally. And as we know, this region likes to jump ahead and skip a few steps in terms of the evolution. So I would not expect this region to go through the whole history of what Europe or Asia has done in VAT, but actually jump a few steps along the way. So things like, you know, having a real-time reporting for the government is one thing. The use of blockchain is another one, where there is a huge pledge by the government here, especially in this region, to try to be blockchain ready by 2020 or 2022. So there is a lot of these things happening, which as a finance function, as a company, you have to bear in mind. And one of the things that you can help you with that, again, is looking at what tools are available to be able to help you there. So one of the things that we are seeing at the moment is a trend around a tax consolidation point of your source system, which means that all data is fed into one place, and that place is then used by all the other functions for tax purposes, which is brilliant. And that's how you can then start to be able to cope with any requirements coming from any government, because your data is ready and there is no loads of manual work around it to try to get to a VAT return. So this is just a thing that you have to keep in the back of your mind as you go along that VAT process, because these things will happen sooner rather than later. And the final thing really is, if you are here in the UAE and Saudi and you have operation in other countries in this region, is obviously, you know, learning from what you have done here and, you know, try to improve the next time how you're gonna get ready for it. That's also really trying to not repeat the same mistake that you might have done here for the next one. We'll be right back.